During this time of year, we often think about helping those in need, and that is exactly where Contact 7 comes in.
And it's all because one Denver woman saw that need right across the street from her home. Liz Gilardi shows us why she felt moved to help her neighbors and how you can help too.
Winter essentials that you would find on store shelves.
Campbell's pork and beans. We've got some Progresso.
Here, the store aisle is a sidewalk.
Hand warmers, some tuna.
And everything is free.
This is our way to say, hey, someone cares. We don't want you to be hungry. We don't want you to be cold.
An unlikely place for a food pantry. It sits outside Annalise Whitfield's Denver home near the corner of 13th and Allottie.
He was such a kind man.
She's talking about her neighbor, Al. He lived across the street in a tent. He was homeless.
This pantry is dedicated to Al because we were his neighbors.
On November 25th, she woke up and saw police across the street.
So someone had found him in the morning. We learned that he had passed. Okay.
Annalise had just installed the pantry the night before. She knew right then she would name it after Al as a tribute to his life.
We can't do nothing. We can't do nothing. It's time to do something. And this is a call to action for me.
Police told us they responded to 13th Avenue the morning Al died. He was 58 years old. His full name is Albert Herrera. We found out he has a brother in Grand Junction, and he was touched to learn the pantry will help others in the community.
Ideally, I would love to see people come by and stock it with what they can.
Keeping others fed and warm.
And so this pantry, Al's pantry, is to keep his memory alive.
Spreading love, compassion, and kindness. Liz Gilardi, Denver 7.
A touching memorial there. Annalise is accepting food donations at her home. We've posted all that information online. She's also started a fundraiser and already collected nearly $1,000 to make sure that pantry is stocked.